is anointed like they raises. Send us out in the earth with prayer, music, and word. Playing dragons to dirt and stuffing them to the curb. Mantles full of his glory, snapping, have every curse. Kingdom going berserk, cause I don't mean you disperse. Your banner strapped in your armor, helmets on and we blazing. Place in place with our shields for the devils we facing. Running gospel to nations, rocking truth like a station. Wave throwing the swords for Christ the King, he amazing. Church over we kingdom, precepts we mean them. Living led by his love, that means we've seen them. Lost souls we bring them, God's ways we've seen them. To carry the news of the truth of that Julian and rose from the dead and redeemed them. Lord, reigning from the heaven with a sword, made it to the image of the poor. And I never valid in the valley, never took over running in the battle we wore. We don't want to give us everything to more. Jesus Christ, he that Lord. Nobody did what he needed, nobody did that one we saw for. Wait.
Hope everybody is blessed today. I'm so excited. I'm so excited. And I still can't sing. But I don't care because I'm about to lose control and I think I'm stupid. Got that right. And nobody else say that. I can talk about myself and it's not offensive. But nah, ladies and gentlemen, this is Gospel Wave. And you guys are tuned in at the right place at the right time. You know, I was thinking about something last night, man. I was really trying to put together a very deep and ministerial, I don't know if that's a real word, but we're going to make it one, message for you guys today. And I was thinking, I had no idea what I was going to talk about. Now, I reach that point all the time. I'm always trying to create something new, and I just never seem to quite get it, you know? It's like, man, it always happens last second. I try to plan for like a month and nothing. And then suddenly right before it's about to happen, boom, there it goes. And so I was thinking last night, I came up with this amazing thought. I'm like, man, hold on. This is amazing. Hold on. I got to say this on the show tomorrow. I'm like, I should write this down. Well, I didn't. I'm thinking to myself, well, if it's the Lord's will, I'll remember. And I was seriously thinking that last. I'm like, if it's the Lord's will, I remember, right? So this morning, I'm thinking about what I'm going to say, and I come to the realization that I completely forgot. Now, I'm praying and, you know, hoping that the Lord will give me what to say. And then I remembered last night when I said, well, if it's the Lord's will, then he'll allow me to remember. And I realized, and I cannot be the only one, but I'm going to admit it live on the air. I'm sitting there thinking to myself, we use this as an excuse to be lazy. Well, I'm not going to write it down because the Lord will let me remember. Or I'm not going to do this because if it's the Lord's will, he'll just give it to me. I'm not going to push and do a whole bunch of work for this because if it's the Lord's will, he's going to bless me with it. And I'm thinking to myself, how many times have we used that excuse? If it's the Lord's will, he's just going to give it to me. Now, will he just give you stuff? Yes, no doubt. He loves you. He wants to bless you with the desires of your heart. But how many things do we still have to work for? How many goals do we have that it takes something to achieve? And I associated that with me being a gospel artist. After I got into social media, about 4 or 5 months after my first album, I got into social media, made some pages, promoted some music, and I'm like, all right, cool. But I realized that I was a very selfish artist. You know, when it came down to it, and I'm sorry, I'm talking all hyper. Normally I'm more calm in the beginning, but I had too much coffee. But I was thinking, you know, I wanted to share my music. Initially I was sharing my music. I wanted everyone's opinion, support, downloads, streaming, listen, whatever, views. I was trying to get it all, but I would not support anybody else. Now, if you guys are artists out there, you probably know exactly what I'm talking about. Everyone's like, yeah, I support you. I appreciate that, man. I'll definitely share your stuff around and then nothing ever happens. Especially when you're the one sharing their stuff and they don't ever share your stuff. Oh, well, I'm too busy. I didn't have time. Man, you got time to do 5 Twitter posts. You could have made that one of them. Simple as that. Now, I'm not hating because I'm not saying that we're supposed to be sharing other people's music so our music gets shared. But I'm saying that you get what you give. You know, it's a game of give and take. If you can really support a whole bunch of people in what they're doing, and let's just be more specific, doing independent gospel music. If you support independent gospel artists who are like the stars of tomorrow, and you share their stuff around, you try to cross-promote, make connections, you know, become friends in the ministry, have that relationship, you know, a lot more people will come too. If you want more people to shake your hand, you got to shake more people's hands. You want more people to share your music, you got to share more people's music. Now, of course, you know, you can, and let's just associate this part with Facebook. You can post Lecrae songs, Hillsong, Mary Mary, Tamala Mann. You can share all of them, but what about the people that's not like millionaires? You know, what about the folks that is like, I don't know, they got 5 followers. You know, let's just take something. They just posted 1 song, really don't know what to do with it. You don't want to give them advice because, you know, then they might take your ideas. Then they might become more successful than you, become more popular than you. And let's face it, I'm not even going front. And if y'all got something to say about this, 646-716-7958. No matter how deep in the gospel you are, there's always a piece of you that wants to become successful and wants to become, I'm just saying this just to make a point, rich and famous. It's not, well, as long as I could be poor all my life, as long as I save 1 soul, that's great. That's an amazing attitude to have, and if you really mean it, you are so blessed to even feel that way. But there's still a piece of you that wants to be successful, man. But we want to do what it takes for everyone to check out our stuff, and nobody really, you know, gets support from us and vice versa. We self, and we acted like a secular artist. And I'll give you another example here. I was sharing the Gospel Wave video. You know, you guys have been blessing us with views and whatnot and getting back to us through the website. By the way, gospelwaveradio.com, everybody. Nevertheless, you know, I posted it in the group, and somebody posted in the comment and said, hey, interesting show. I couldn't listen to it all, but I'll definitely come back to it. Don't know if they did or not, but it was blessed just to get a comment, you know. Somebody else left a comment and said, cool radio show. Check out my radio show. And then they left a link for it. I'm like, who's this swagger jacking man? You know, I posted my last music video for Abba Don't Cry. And someone said, hey, cool song. Check out my song, my mixtape here. Download free. I'm like, dude, stop swagger jacking off my promotion, man. Why don't you just post it and tag me in it? That's just straight up ignorant. And then it shows that you're desperate. If you that desperate, stop doing music. Simple as that. See, I have no problem. I play independent music all the time, man. You ain't got to swagger jack off promotion. Nevertheless, getting back on track, these folks that is in that particular manner swagger jacking, but that won't really share your music, share somebody else's music, and they won't have anything to do with you unless you're like really, really up there, you're really big. And then they don't really particularly care about, you know, your music or what you're doing. They only want their music out there. There's no part of them doing it for the kingdom. They're doing it to get rich. They're trying to use God to get rich. Now, there's a lot more to get into it, but I ain't got that much time. Nevertheless, we're going to be talking about this a little bit today. But, yeah, there's a lot of folks that use God just to try to get out there, get rich or popular, and they'll sit back. Yeah, man, well, God blessed, you know, I'm just thankful for this, that, and no, you're not. Let's just be real. You swagger jacked off other people. You never supported no one else. You finally made it big, and you're trying to say God this. That's like Eminem after he made all those songs about raping women and killing babies. That's like him going on stage talking about, yeah, well, I just thank Jesus for letting me get that far. Thank Jesus. You're preaching the devil on stage. Now, I know I'm jumping around, but this all has the same theme here. You give or you get what you give. You know, so the whole moral, I'm just going to sum this all up because I got like 2 minutes left. The sum up is this. If you want the support from other people, you have to show it. Are you going to get it immediately? No. Are you going to get a whole bunch of it at once? Probably not. But look at it like this. I've had so many people that I've helped promote them. They never promoted back, and they've been out 5 times longer than I have, and now I'm already bigger than they are. You know, reputation-wise, making sales, becoming popular and whatnot, and they're trying to figure out why. It's because, and I'm one of the most non-people people you'll ever meet. I'm all cool on the radio. I'll talk to my associates, my friends and stuff, but I ain't a people person. I can be by myself for like a year and be okay. You know, I actually prefer it. The Lord is working on my heart on that manner, so I'm making more connections and friends and whatnot. But nevertheless, you know, I mean, if you're not sharing anybody's stuff, you can't expect someone else to do it. If you're not supporting somebody and even, you know, give them some criticism, man. You know, this sounds good at this part, but I would change and fix that. Cool. Now, if you're going to give it, learn how to take it. Because someone says, well, I don't think the mix and mastering is that good. And you're like, oh, well, bump you. You don't know what you're talking about. That right there, you ain't never going to make it. That's just a little side tip. Nevertheless, you want support, you got to give it. Any kind of support you want, give it. Take 5 seconds of the day. Well, I don't have that much time. Well, then miss an hour of sleep and do it. Or, you know, every morning, like what I do is I'm going to start doing this from now on. Every morning before the radio show, I'm going to do at least one post on all my social media things except the IG. So I'm always on there. And Lord willing, at least half of it's going to be supporting somebody else and something else. As long as it's Christian-based, we're going to do it. I'm going to have to wrap it up here. I'm getting a sign from the producer saying that, Doctrinn, you talk way too dang much. And I'm jumping around way too much today, but we got 2 hours of show. We're going to be talking about this, supporting, gaining what you give. And then we're also going to be talking about this. If the Lord has it for you, will he just give it to you, or do you have to work for it? But Doctrinn talked too much, so we're going to have to jump into a song. So we're going to support a newer, well, not a newer artist, but an artist we haven't played a song by in a while. They just dropped a new single. My buddy Brother War. He just dropped a new single called Bow, and I have not had a chance to listen to the whole one, but he did send it to me, so we're going to play it today, and we're going to be right back.
This game is dirty. This system is just designed to keep you blind. This game is dirty. This system is just designed to keep you blind. You've been tricked by the trap. If you think this paraphernalia gives you any more value, whoop tickets, what they always sell you, what they always tell you, to keep you in prison, the industrial complex. They only just want tech. Queens want a king, but you only just want next. Running through one with no delay like a relay. Daddy disappeared and broke your heart, now it's a replay. But I wanna introduce you to your father heavenly. He got the remedy, he promised that he'll never leave. He wants you part of his family in this heavenly kingdom, cause you was made for more and greater things can be achieved. If you just believe, if you just receive, he paid the ultimate price, brother, but for you it's free. You can try to fight it, you can try to deny it, you can try to keep running, but the father is pursuing you. And now the choice is yours, it's up to you what you're gonna do. This game is dirty, this system is designed just to keep you blind. Bow, 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 bow your head and pray. Our God is really calling you a greater love you never find. Bow, 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 bow your head and pray. This game is dirty, this system is designed just to keep you blind. Bow, 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 bow your head and pray. Our God is really calling you a greater love you never find. Bow, 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 bow your head and pray. Maybe some point in your life you felt like you could never ever fit in with the church. They just treated you like some dirt. God is so much bigger than the box they represent him in. Can't you feel him knocking at your heart? It's time to let him in. And maybe you just feel like you ain't ready, cause you're not strong enough to let go of these petty distractions and diversions and habitual perversion. But God has got a better plan, and he is so determined to rescue you and save you from yourself if you just let him. And ask him to reveal himself to you if you never met him. Bow your head and pray, pray. Yeshua coming to my heart, I surrender it all to you. I repent of everything that I've done in life that wasn't cool. I know you paid the price for me, I'm asking you to be my Lord and Savior, take these chains, break them, set me free with liberty. And now I'm giving you all of me. This game is dirty, this system is designed just to keep you blind. Bow, 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 bow your head and pray. Our God is really calling you a greater love you never find. Bow, 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 bow your head and pray. This game is dirty, this system is designed just to keep you blind. Bow, 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 bow your head and pray. Our God is really calling you a greater love you never find. Bow, 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 bow your head and pray.
Your life has so much more value than what you think it does. What the system system has blinded you to think that you have to buy things to be somebody. When God made you in his image and his likeness, and he has such a better plan, a much better plan for you. But you gotta respect the man that you are, the man that you were made to be, no matter what you've done, no matter how many mistakes you've made. The God came to redeem you. He sent his son to redeem you, to change everything. Are you gonna be man enough to stand up and be the man that you were made to be? Don't throw it all away. We need you. God bless you. Salute. In Yahshua's name.
Billie Jean and I dab. Billie Jean and I dab. I'm Peter Pan with a swag. I can't sing this other part on the radio. What's up, y'all? This is the Gospel Wave. 646-716-7958. I know I was jumping around on my message a lot. I really did not have enough time to cover everything I was going to say. That was about a quarter of it. So different pieces and parts is going to be coming out in the show. But it's all right, because you know what? As long as a piece of a message blesses you, you can, if you're a creative person, you'll come up with your own message from that. You ever get somebody's testimony and it's just like they did a whole hour of preaching, man, but they said that one thing that stuck with me, and then it gets you thinking, you know, what if I apply it to this, and then that actually kind of relates to that, and now next thing you know, you're on your own ministry tip talking about the same thing. So, yeah, everybody has the opportunity to call in. We don't promote nearly as much as we should, but we're going to start. But again, 646-716-7958. Press that one key. Let us know you want to come on live. And I've got my team, Kimmie K and KP. We're going to call him KP because that's a little more gangster. Well, I got them both with me today. How you guys doing?
All right, I'm blessed. How about you?
I'm hyped up on coffee.
Well, I'm going to get that way in a minute. Okay.
Thank God for coffee, man.
Oh, yes. Now, that coffee bean is mighty. And, yes.
The mighty holy coffee bean.
That's right. You know what? And I think I'm going to call Columbia today and tell them that I've got an idea. I mean, that was inspired by Doctrinn. A mighty holy coffee bean. Yes. And they can produce it. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, but you gotta have some sort of strawberry or cherry flavor to it. And then you can't use regular water.
No.
You gotta make the coffee with holy water.
Oh no. See, the holy water I can do myself. See, what I can do is when I turn the sink on, okay, I turn the water on in the sink, you get the water and put it in the coffee pot, I bless it. And automatically it becomes holy water. Pour it out of the sink. It's okay.
Holy tap water, y'all.
Hey, tap water can be holy water, too. All you gotta do is bless it.
Man, tripped out. Hey, Kimmie K, yeah. How are you doing today?
I'm good. How are you?
Still hyped up on coffee. I tell you what, man, I drink this coffee any faster, man. I'm gonna be jumping up and down. Next song we play, I'm gonna be headbanging so hard, my computer gonna jump off the desk and right onto the floor.
Okay. You hear me waving your hand in the air, waving your hands up in the air, waving like you just don't care why you do that. There you go, yeah.
I tried that last night while I was recording. It didn't work. I had went to the store and I decided to buy like a 20-ounce Red Bull, so I drank the whole thing. And I decided I got so much energy, I'm gonna record something right now. So I went ahead and I started recording. And I found out two things. One, you should not be dancing around while you're recording because it came out perfect. I'm like, yes. After 10 times, it came out perfect. But you can hear me jumping around like a monkey also on the mic. So it's hard sometimes to just not be dancing and grooving to it. But, hey, but the second thing, and it's the one thing that I think Kimmie K can relate to because we're both artists. We both had this experience. You're singing a song. It sounds good. It's like, yes, it's finally done, finished, recorded, boom. And then you sit down, you listen to it, and you realize you hit a flat note somewhere. And now you're like, man, I really don't want to go back and do it because now I'm tired. I was all excited, but now I got to go re-record that part.
Oh, man.
What are you doing, man?
So what?
What are you doing?
What am I doing?
KennP, Doctrinn, how was your weekend?
I was very intrigued about what KennP doing. It sounded like he's trying to scratch his back itch.
I know, right?
Yeah, there we go.
Oh, yeah.
Well, he's running around for an hour trying to scratch his back.
Hey, it's okay. I mean, my back is scratching sometimes. It's okay. anyway, this weekend, for the church service, wow, I was really blessed. I did actually four services altogether this past Sunday, and altogether, God through me, we managed to get over 35 people to come to know the Lord this yesterday. It was a blessed day.
Yes.
How was your weekend?
Well, my weekend was quite trying. I'm grieving the loss of a family member, so you guys pray for the family. But it's always a blessing to just be able to wake up, you know, and see another day. Sometimes you take that for granted. I just feel like, you know, sometimes funerals make you sad, and you think about the moments that you had with the person, and then at the same time, you know, people rejoice because, you know, you're going to be with the Lord.
You got to think about that, Kimmie K. Okay? That person may not woke up to see another day here on earth, but, you know, he woke up and saw a day in heaven. I mean, what a day can that be? Woo!
I try to crack, like, little jokes about that just to make people smile. Like, you know, while we're sitting down here, you know, just trying to make the music, God's got all the gospel music we're making now, God's got up there listening to it, and you got all your relatives that decide that it was their time to go home. They up there doing the Tootsie Roll with the Lord and Savior, just loving the music and dancing to it. So as we make it, they jam to it.
Amen.
Just imagine that happening right now. That makes you smile, huh? Yeah, that's wonderful. That's a wonderful imagination to think about that.
Oh, yeah.
It's the way you said it, though. So you have a wonderful imagination. I'm like, wow. I don't know how to take that.
If you close your eyes for a minute and just think of everybody in a white, you know, in white attire, and they're just smiling and they're looking down, and I say, oh, look at, you know, listen to the beat Doctrinn just made. You know, his lyrics is on point. Everything sounds good, and they're just dancing around in heaven, and you're just imagining that. That's a beautiful imagination.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I mean, I imagine that quite a bit, actually. Okay, because I imagine every time that we save a soul down here, that everybody up in heaven, okay, is rejoicing. Okay, I know the angels rejoice every time we save someone. So I figure if the angels rejoice, okay, so does everybody else up in heaven. They're saying, wow,
yeah,
everybody,
absolutely. Yeah. Like we make, you know, like sometimes, you know, they smile and they rejoice because we just make their life a little bit more easier because they don't have to work as hard because, you know, we have our angels working for us every day because of things that we do. We have those guardian angels guiding us and keeping us from a car accident or, you know, like so when we're making lyrics that inspire and making lyrics that can change the life of someone, we could be helping. I feel like at the end of the day, we, you know, made an angel job more easier because they don't have to work as hard because they listen to a song from Kimberly or Doctrinn or any other inspirational artist.
No, they ain't playing some of my music in heaven. There's some of my music they ain't gonna play in heaven. Like you can play it in heaven, but whoever played it's going back down to hell. It's like, I'm with the Lord. I like this. And you know, because I bleep, then I bleep, but then all they hear is the pink earrings. And it's like, you know, once you start hearing that bleep, I know in heaven you're supposed to know more, but I mean, I feel like there's some of my music that ain't going to play bleeping.
I think any music that has a lyrics in it that inspire, or lyrics that just kind of teach you something, or, you know, that type of lyrics that kind of change you from doing something bad into something good, I think that at the end of the day, that all matters. I don't think that your music will be frowned upon at all in heaven. I think that they'll be able to rejoice because you put a little bit of, you know, the world in it, where you can reach the world, and at the end of the day, your music still inspires them to do something, you know, better. So I don't agree with you, Doctrinn.
Huh. Yeah, when you put it like that, I can feel you. Doesn't help me trying to crack these jokes, though. So, we're going to move on to this next subject here. We're going to play a song, since ain't nobody laughing at my jokes. They just coming against it. It's not ha-ha, Doctrinn. It's not you wrong, Doctrinn. I see what kind of day this is going to be. This is Gospel Waves with KennP and Kimmie K. Doctrinn ain't funny no more. So, we're going to jump into a song that just happens to be by Kimmie K. Because this song we have not played on the show just yet. And so I believe, because I had somebody else upload this for me, so this better be the right song. But it's a song called You Matter.
Oh, wow. Yay.
I guess that means that's her song. All right, cool. I thought, now let's just hope this is her song and it's not, you know, we're going to play a song by her and we got somebody with a deep voice like Isaac Hayes come on. That'll be embarrassing for the entire network. We're going to play You Matter. What? Actually got you to make the song You Matter? What was you going through to write that? I wanted to ask that first.
Well, definitely You Matter is a representation of just everybody matter. You know, I know a lot of times things that's been happening in the world that's been directly affecting us African-American people. A lot of the killings, the shootings, a lot of the police hate, and, you know, just You Matter. Not only am I trying to let those who've been affected by gun violence know that you do matter. We do see you. There are people out there that see you, hear you, and understand your struggle. And at the same time, I'm talking about just everybody else that's just going through it, that just have struggles in other areas of their life. You matter. And it is people out there that believe that you matter and that do really see you and understand what you're going through. And I just want to be a part of the movement to kind of, you know, spread the message of love, peace, and just happiness and unity. And you matter, you know. So that's the reason why that song was written.
Fair enough. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Kimmie K, a.k.a. Kimberly Kimberly. You matter.
Listen. fit. See the fire lit, who they gonna get? That's another man down that you see. Next he gonna have his name on the grave, slipping sound as can be. It's a chain and the actions, the outcome of pain. They see through exist, they were caught in their aim. Maybe he was walking the streets, maybe he's a thief. Couldn't hear him preach, fight with police, now he's gone. Never lived half of his life, those are plans for a future. Ain't no kids or a wife, the others wanna join. Say they really can't deny it, get the torches, make the t-shirts. We gonna start a riot, hoping that they try it. The motive's undecided, now the whole neighborhood is invited. Okay, they'll come asking questions, look past what he did. Who he said, who he was, and he was a good kid. We'll go to the street with the ruckus. Don't look at me mad, cause I'm fighting for justice. Trust in the words of the king, really can't follow it, but you can guess what I mean. Wonder if the world could change, witty, instead of having fear in his eyes for a man in a hoodie. No one ever said what we live in is nice, so you gotta think twice or entice, so you pay the price.
Black lives matter.
Come on. Hey. So let me go and talk about this journey. Music always walk you with me. More like I was chasing it. I guess I got some talking in me. I know the cross is with me. I'm just trying to keep it real. Struggling these days to find a couple ways that I can heal. I'm managing but damaging every day of mine. Having kids and doing music always gotta make the time. I'm traveling the world with dirty diapers in my purse. Just trying to write a verse but have no place I can rehearse it. When motherhood calls you answer, never think twice about it. See my daughter's faces, I'm reminded I can't live without them. But check the truth of life. Hard to balance but I choose this life. Good, this was my call and now I'm feeling there's no proof I'm right. You my right to hold this mic but my passion shifted. Hashtag mommy rapper just in case you missed it. Through it all I'm still doing this in hopes that I can bring a change. Let them know your girl is still here, I'm unashamed.
I changed for the better. Map games are so insane, but I'ma make it through the weather.
Sometimes I just hear myself singing, it sounds really good. Then other times I hear myself sing somebody else's stuff, and it really sucks.
What?
Hey, let's just keep it real. Ain't no singer always good at all the time.
I think you're doing a wonderful thing, Doctor, and I think we are all our worst critics. So sometimes us as an artist is just going to, you know, just criticize our own self. You know, but it's good that we have people that look in on it. You know, the people, the outsiders looking in can always see it better and hear it better than what, you know, than what we hear. So that's a good thing about your music, so that people can, you know, give their opinion. And I think it sounds great.
Good thing.
Yeah.
I mean, you definitely right about it. Even God had to tell me one time that we're our own worst critics. There was a, I think my omission and my confession is I just don't like my own voice. I was doing my song yesterday. I'm like, I had to redo everything like 20 times. I'm not even exaggerating. Had to keep doing it over and over again in order to get it to sound halfway decent. At some point, I just said, you know what, bump it. I'm just going to sing the way I want to sing. And just listening to it, I mean, it came out pretty good. I think it could be better if it was somebody's better voice. But, you know, that's why I feel like if you guys are independent artists out there, man, try this. Get 3 to 5 of your closest friends that you know is going to be positive and honest with you about everything. You know, give you criticism, good and bad. And before you actually release your music, let them hear it and get their feedback. Maybe you can re-record a piece here and there and maybe add something, take something away. Just get their feedback. I got a buddy that actually does that. And, you know, I'm one of his, I'm not going to say who it is, but I'm one of his, you know, inner circle, I guess you would say. And he lets me hear some of his music. And, you know, he asks for my opinions. And not everything I say he's going to follow, but he gets, it's not just me, it's like 5 of us, but he gets all of our opinions, takes them into consideration, and then, you know, tries to make edits to try to make the best project possible. So I feel like doing something like that would be advantageous. Kimmie, have you ever done something like that? Do you have that?
Which part, like, do I have that?
Do you have people that you just let hear your music and they give you your opinions and, you know, at the end, you decide if you want to make those changes or not?
Kind of, I would say. Not within the studio, but more after the fact. And when I let, you know, my family members hear the song after I've recorded it in the studio, they'll, you know, tell me what they think at that point. But when I'm actually in the studio, it would be nice to have that person that's listening, you know, from the outside listening in. But no, I don't. Not
okay,
until
so
all do. I mean, you know what?
Huh?
The engineer and the producers, I mean, the engineer is very, very helpful. The producers, you know, it's a lot of people that actually that work with me during the writing process. Like the engineer also, you know, well, you know, the engineer that actually worked with me during in the studio and with the recording and all of that. He's awesome. So, yeah, so actually he doesn't directly tell me what to say or how to, well, actually not what to say, but he gives me feedback as to, okay, say this again, say it more stronger, you know, like say, you know, something like that. So actually, yeah, I do have help before the actual song is recorded. Yeah, from the engineer and some of the producers. But as
far
as
those of y'all that can afford engineers and producers. See, the one thing you got to understand about Kimmie K is that she puts out high quality music because she put the effort in and she does it as many times as she needs to get it up there. But she works with a lot of several different kind of producers and engineers to try to get the best sound possible. That's what you need to do. That ain't always what the rest of us do because we don't like taking people's advice because we stupid. But, you know, she decided to, like, how long did it take you to make Laugh at the Devil, the full album?
The full album, it took about 2 years.
Yeah, I ain't finna waste no 2 years on the album. I do a couple of months. See?
Yeah, it took two years because I definitely wanted to bring you guys something different to the table, something that will really inspire you, something that you would really be able to feel. So it took 2 years because I was doing a lot of thinking, a lot of praying, and I also worked with a lot of people that, you know, it took time to kind of create the beat that I really was feeling. And, you know, also it takes time and money. I would say money would be the longest process because it does take money, and the people that I work with, they're definitely not cheap. So, yeah, it took 2 years. My next album, I definitely would like for it to be much, much quicker, be completed much, much quicker, like at least less than a year. side. The next album that
I'm
working on.
General, artists generally release out one album a year. And I don't know. I guess everybody works differently. Some artists, it takes them a year to actually compile an album. Lord has me do it kind of like, you know, high school. You know, you take a couple of months out to write, record, put it all together, you release it, and then you got about 6 to 8 months of just promoting it, performing it, and stuff like that. So, I mean, the Lord works with everybody different, but, I mean, you're doing 2 years, so that means that's 2 years of trying to put the instrumentals together from scratch, make everything perfect, make sure your lyrics are really tight and fit perfectly, got the language right, as me and Rio was saying before, and then make sure that you got your vocals in the right condition to sing it as perfect as you want it to be. See, that's the best part about being a rapper, man. We ain't got to do all that. I could be on the track. Yeah, I'm getting louder. My Jesus Christ, I'm prouder. Whoop, whoop. Hakuna Matata. And, I mean, literally, people be like, yo, that's tight, though, man. I'm like, yeah, that's because y'all stupid, man. But, I mean, that's about up there with mumble rap, but I can do that and it would actually work. Rap doesn't take too much skill anymore. It used to take skill. Now it's just as long as you're saying something that somewhat rhymes. But singing in itself, you have to have, I think everybody has a natural singing voice, but not everybody has the range that they want. There's a lot of tunes that I would love to do. Can't believe I just said tunes. But that, and there's a lot of pitches that I would like to be able to hit correctly, but my voice, my vocal range isn't that broad yet to hit those correct pitches. There'll be flat notes. I've never once sang to where, you know, you start off like, oh, I ain't never did nothing like that without me goofing off and just trying to be funny, because I know if I record that, then, you know, I'm just going to delete it in a second, and nobody really need to hear that. But practice don't make perfect, but sometimes practice makes better. Unless, of course,
right.
You just can't sing.
And then it's always longer first doing something. So I anticipate that, you know, my future work will be much quicker. So a year, you will be getting something new from me every year.
I hope it's so. I mean, your Laughter Double album is going pretty good. Hey, what kind of support have you gotten for that album anyway?
As far as support fans.
Like what I was talking about earlier in the show. You know, like people sharing your stuff, you sharing their stuff, and if you cross-promoted with artists, does that become, like, advantageous for your career?
I think the weakest part of being an artist is getting that support needed. And I think that if we actually, maybe it's because of my lack of communicating to them that, okay, pass this around. Because evidently people just don't automatically do it. You have to kind of reach out to them and let them know. So I think I'm a little slow at getting people to, you know, help. I guess my pride per se, or maybe I just don't want to bother people with, you know, helping me out, because my mom always told me people only help those who already made it. They're not going to help you try to get there, because everybody's trying to make it. So that's why it's so important to fake it till you make it. I think I can do better to reaching out with my, you know, to my family members and my friends to just say, hey, y'all, share this around, pass this around, and you know, just because I think they would.
Huh? You still there? Okay, we lost Kimmie K. Well, nevertheless, I guess while we're having these technical difficulties, I should let you know, half of our message today was sponsored by the U.S. Postal Service. If you want something really expensive and thrown on your porch and then somebody stealing it before you get home, go to the U.S. Postal Service. I actually Swagger Jacked that from a TV show, but I was trying to be funny. Hopefully somebody laughed. I think it just went over everyone's heads. But I'm not peanuts, so I can't go over them and then it'd be funny. So Adrian Blue out of Colorado, he's got a new song that's going to drop tonight called Walk With Jesus, featuring some weird guy named Doctrinn. Hopefully somebody know who that is. Hey. It actually comes out tonight, so be on the lookout. It'll be all over our page as well. But we're going to jump into that for the first time to be heard. And, you know, if anybody wants to call in, you know, we're getting ready to bring our guest on, and we got a couple of surprises for you. But 646-716-7958, press that one key to let us know you want to come on live, and we will do the thing up. Because remember, Jesus isn't only the reason for the season, but the reason that you're breathing is because you're no longer a heathen. You're saved. Let's go.
Dangerous endeavors astray from the past that God has us on. Living life moment to moment, all that's left in the fragments. Left a piece of yourself in the ground feeling tragic. So take a leap of faith, take a dive off a cliff, and have the faith that you'll be carried by a grace. Still clinging to a place, hoping to vanish without a trace. Too afraid of my digression, that's been my crying obsession now. Way too many lives have been lost, passing away from our vanity. Seems to jeopardize faith in it all, but we made that call. That's the narrow path that we chose.
No one said it'd be easy, but that's the only path that we know.
Faith be shown,
words be known,
spirit grown,
light behold.
Call us to the Savior from a place that's black and cold.
If I don't have a purpose for the Savior, then just close your eyes, cause in a few moments my soul will be dead and gone.
On the counter and the empty of his soul. Caught up in the moment, you just wanna have control. It lets him pushing all your buttons, so you've been a lonely mo. Try to stay afloat, but then you get caught in the undertow. And when you think of all your goals, it's a game with all the pain. It's a game with all the play. Is the reason to the rhyme when you read between the lines? Is it treasure that you find, or another lonely night where you muster all your fight just to try to stay alive? But you're never gonna cry, right? But you're never gonna cry, right?
We are the brokenhearted, we fall in love and on. And when this world fails us, we must trust in our Lord's place.
Sometimes, you just gotta stop and breathe. Look around, take in everything you have, everything you don't have. It's a blessing, man. God will never leave you, He will never forsake you. Through your highs, your lows, your highs. Praise God, man. He is good.
When I sin, when I slip and fall down, His grace abounds all around me.
When I fail and I sail into the deep sea of heathen, I will drown if I don't walk with Jesus.
Ladies and gentlemen, that was Adrian Blue with Walk With Jesus. He's going to be on next week's show, so he's going to explain why he called it that. I know why he called it that, but I mean, I'm going to let him explain it because it's always better to come from the artist. So, KennP, let me ask you something, dog.
Yeah.
We've been nominated for several awards, man, and we only started this back in November.
Right.
You think we're letting it go to our head?
I don't know. I'm not letting it go to my head. Are you letting it go to your head?
Heck yeah, man. Because, see, I'm sitting there like, man, you know how many radio hosts I know And out of all of them, we got nominated for stuff, and we just got nominated for another award that we still got to make a post about. But man, it's a blessing, though, because I never thought it'd go this far. And we practically just started. We ain't even been out for a year.
Well, you know, if we put out a good message and people like it, they're going to nominate. That's all the way it goes. You know, well, what do we get nominated for now?
Oh, I can't stay on the air just yet. We're going to have to advertise that one. It's another gospel radio, but it's a lot bigger than the ones we've been nominated with.
Okay.
All right, so cool. Let me ask you something, man. Do you remember KD the Vessel from Chicago?
Yeah.
You remember his song, Worship?
Yeah, and 3.0 and... Yeah.
Have you ever heard of a song, Reconciled?
That one I haven't heard yet.
But that's on his album, too. A Heart United for Worship. Keep wanting to say reunited.
Okay.
But we're going to play both of those songs, actually. But I wanted to get your opinion on Reconciled. So we're going to play that. We're going to play that right after Worship.
Okay. All right.
But I want to get your opinion because I know how eclectic you are, man. You'll be playing This Little Light of Mine and just have like the house beat in the background. I'm like, who made this stuff? And I'm not going to lie. There's some music you play on your shows and I just think it's whack. I ain't going to say it on the air. But see, this gospel wave, I don't ever play something I don't like. You can pay me all the money in the world. If I don't like your music, it ain't getting played. I'm sorry. I can't sit there and be fake and pretend I like your stuff when I don't.
You don't like that song?
I do a little bit. I like the house beat.
Okay. I just think it's a great worship song to listen to because, you know,
it's a great worship song, but it's a good song in itself. I think they could have went a different way with it and done a lot more with it.
Well, I think for the song itself, This Little Light of Mine, the way they put it together with that type of a club beat, I think they did really well. Like I said, I don't know who it was by. It doesn't say. But I think they did a really good job. Think about it. They're independent artists, and for the quality that a lot of independent artists go through. Like a lot of them are not really in studios. Some of them are doing it on a house mix, by getting some beats put down and putting it out, I think they did a really good job,
I ain't saying they didn't do a good job. I just think they could have went in. It's kind of like my first album, man. I dropped a couple songs, and I probably could have done a lot more with those songs, but I just put them out because I was in a rush, just to finally have something out there.
Maybe they did that too. Who knows? I think it's a good song. It can get the Holy Spirit moving. You can put your hands up in the air, like I said, wave them like you just don't care, that's what I play music. If it moves me, then I know it's going to move others, But I do like to find the music out there that's kind of unusual to be played for, like gospel music or a sort. But I think that's a great thing because, the more music you hear that's worshiping God, it brings you to a better understanding of God to me. I heard some music the other day that was done in French. And I'm going to try to get that downloaded for the people that live up in Canada, because there are a lot of French-speaking individuals in Canada. So it would be great to play some of their music, play some music that they can hear in their native tongue, you know? So I'm gonna try to do that.
I got a couple of friends that do gospel hip-hop down in, like, Mexico and Puerto Rico. I play their music sometimes. But, I mean, this show got listeners all over the world, though. Now, we got people in Africa and Asia that want to call in because they listen to it, like, regularly, religiously, but they can't call America. So, if y'all listen to that, shout out, man. Go to gospelwaveradio.com and just go ahead and hit the submit button on the, I almost said love letter, to the fan mail, and just send us something in, man. We'll give you a shout out and read your letter on the air. We're going to jump into a couple songs, and then we're going to bring on our special celebrity guest, Miz Tiffany. I know y'all know the name, but do y'all know the ministry yet? We're going to find out. 646-716-7958. I see we have plenty of callers already. Just press that one key if you want to come on live, or if you just want to stay tuned in. We appreciate your love and support, because love and support makes the world go round. Jesus gave it to us, and so now it's our obligation to give it to each other. You feel me? We're going to jump into King David, the vessel's worship, and then be reconciled.
Day from you. give my all in worship. Here I am.
Sometimes there's pain, sure as there's joy. You gon' love right, you can't avoid. They'll break your heart and leave it in pieces. To lay down your life makes you more like Jesus. You can spend years trying to act like it's raining your life, when it's really only your tears held on so long. Not to feel weird, I know it hurts, but it can heal. And I know it works, 'cause Jesus will be reconciled. 'Cause you're not as strong as you think you are on your own.
Be reconciled.
'Cause you can't do what you need to do all alone.
Be reconciled.
Life is so much better when you're not bitter and you get up and
reconcile.
Oh, yeah. Left
all alone,
or so it seems.
So it seems.
'Cause they're not moved by your hopes and dreams. Invisible, like no one sees. Don't wanna be bothered. You'd rather bleed. Heart waxing cold, emotions gone. You trusted man, and you trusted wrong. Let down again, broken within. Don't want repair, just hope it mends. See, I know it hurts,
I know it does,
but it can heal.
Oh yes, it can.
I know it works.
Know this,
'cause Jesus will,
oh, yes, he will
be reconciled. 'Cause you're not as strong as you think you are on your own.
Be reconciled,
yeah. Oh. 'Cause you can't do what you need to do all alone.
Be reconciled.
Life is so much better when you're not bitter and you get up.
Be
and
reconciled.
Yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Oh. Time to return.
Come on.
Time to let go. Time to move
on,
and time to grow. No more excuses
for
staying as you were.
Stay that way.
A blessing's waiting.
But first,
let's break the curse. You've dealt with petty. You've sown your scars, and Jesus is waiting.
So you can
come as you are. No more complaining,
more complaining
about what has been.
Let that go.
The pool is ready.
Come on.
Gonna jump back in.
Say what?
It may still hurt.
It may still
feel pain.
I know you may.
But I have one question.
I got one.
Where is your faith?
Where is your faith?
Please don't stay hurt. Please let it heal.
Let it heal.
Realize your worth.
I pray you.
'Cause Jesus did
what you should
be reconciled.
Hey.
Not on your own.
Be reconciled.
Oh, do what you need to do all alone.
Be reconciled.
Life is so much better.
I wish you'd get up.
Be reconciled. Hey, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh.
King David, the vessel right out of Chicago. Ladies and gentlemen, we've got a special guest today. If you don't know where you're about to get mind blown, because when it comes down to actual Christian music, I believe that every piece of Christian music takes a skill, and you got to have a certain skill to actually make Christian music appealing. So, we got somebody in the building that makes it very appealing, lyrically, style-wise, and vocally. Ladies and gentlemen, we got Miz Tiffany in the building. Y'all already know I got to keep it bougie on my show, so there it is. How you doing, Tiffany?
I'm doing great.
Hello.
This morning. How are you?
Oh, we are blessed to have you today.
Yes. Amen. I'm glad to be here. It's a pleasure.
So let me ask you something. Where are you from?
I am from the Deep South, from Jackson, Mississippi.
Okay, because somebody asked me if I was coming to Washington for the show tonight. I'm like, we going to Washington. And I got really confused. I thought somebody had did an advertising mistake. I don't know.
No.
See, if I was.
Look, y'all
I don't
have me laughing all morning long, okay? Since I've been listening to me on the show. I will be in Baltimore, Maryland, on Friday, but... Yes, the Newsom Gospel Music Awards is on Saturday in Baltimore, and I will be receiving several awards there and performing as well. So I'm really excited about that. So, yeah, I'll be in Baltimore.
Yeah, it's time for me to start talking to my manager, wondering why I'm not even knowing about half this stuff.
Well,
y'all may be a radio
manager,
host, but, I mean, anyone that knows me knows I don't know anything.
I
said, like, I don't know nothing about nothing. So what got you into doing Christian music in the first place as opposed to, you know, doing secular music?
Well, I used to be a secular artist years ago, and when I was 20, I was in a car accident. Shortly after that, I really stopped. I stopped writing, you know, I really stopped rapping. I stopped recording in the studios. And, you know, even while I was a secular rapper and I would be in those settings, you know, around, you know, all of the things that were going on, substances is everywhere. And, you know, my spirit always convicted me. I knew that I should not be in those places, but I believe God is strategic and he was preparing. He was giving me that experience with being in the studio and with music and being around other artists. He was preparing me for later on to be able to go back and reach back to those artists, the people that I was around, and now they see me doing something positive, something inspirational. They can receive deliverance through that as well. And so I always believe that, you know, God is perfect and he's sovereign and that he will use things that seem to be negative or bad, and he can flip them and turn them around for our good. And so 4 years ago, I was praying to God and, you know, what do I do from here? You know, I have a bachelor's degree. I have a master's degree. What else do you want me to do? I've glorified you, you know, in that way. But this is not it. This is not it for me. What would you have me do? And he gave me the revelation of, you know, you can still rap, but rap the gospel. And I was like, rap the gospel? I don't have those words. I don't believe that I can write a rap. I haven't written in so long. Can I write a rap that, you know, contains no cursing, that's not glorifying things in the world? I need for you to do this for me, God, because I can't do it. You're going to have to write it. Holy Ghost, you're going to have to reveal it to me. And on that day, I went and purchased a notebook and a pen, and I sat it on the head of my bed, and prophetically, I could see the words on the pages. I could see the book filled. And for 2 months, I didn't write, though. And then all of a sudden, I was convicted again by the Holy Spirit, and he said, if you don't start writing now, it's never going to happen. And I was like, I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it. You know, a few days after that, I was talking to my husband, and I just looked over at him, and I said, well, I ain't preaching to the choir because they already believe. And then I started to sing it and started to rap it a little bit, and
yep.
The words just started to flow. I ran over to that notebook, and I grabbed it. That notebook is filled. I have another notebook. It's filled now. You know, that was 4 years ago. So God has been good to me. And I've just been pushing just that one single and saturating with that. And it has went all over the world. And, you know, I've won many awards. And I'm floored, really, to be honest. I'm really humbled. at all of what's going on right now. And like I said, I don't have managers. I really don't have a team behind me, just me, the Father, the Son, the Holy Ghost, and a few of my family members who have been helping me out with this.
There you go.
Trust me out man, how God uses your everyday situations to inspire you.
Right.
I mean, there's
inspiration in everything.
There's one time the Lord told me to start carrying around a little pocketbook. Like, it's like a little notebook mm-hmm. that you can take quick notes in and keep it in my back pocket. I'm like, what I want to do that for? I got to be obedient,
yeah.
though. So I did. Next thing
yeah.
you know, he starts randomly coming to my mind, and I come up with something that I think is pretty sharp, so I write it down, and it came out in some music. So, I mean, just randomly,
wow.
you're walking down the street and see, like, a flower, you know, somebody's garden, say, that's a beautiful garden. You can tell they take care of their garden, and next thing you know, there's a song about how God's love is beautiful, like a beautiful day in the park with a whole bunch of flowers and people enjoying themselves, sunshiny day. All that came from a flower. I mean, you never know what the Lord
right.
will use, but he never lacks with inspiration.
Absolutely, and I always, you know, I keep my cell phone on me, and if I'm inspired, if I don't have a pen and a pad, I use my voice recorder and, you know, just take down notes like that, too. But, yeah. We're inspired by the things that are around us and the people who are around us as well.
You the kind of person that keeps all your songs and notes in your phone? Like, generally, you're recording out of your phone?
No. I'm a pen and pad person. Like, I prefer writing. But if I'm busy, if I'm out and I don't have access to my notebook, or, you know, I'm doing something, I just get an inspiration. I just pick up the voice recorder, record it, and, you know, give myself some instruction on about what my idea was, what to do with it. And then I come back to the pen and pad, and that's when I go to work. So
that's what I advise everybody to do, because every time you can put everything you have in a smartphone and be like, man, I have it right here. No matter what I have to do today, I'm gonna go back at the end of the day and record this right here, and suddenly you drop your phone, the whole thing breaks, and that's it.
Ah,
you done lost everything. So I write everything in a pad too.
Amen. Yeah, and you should always get prepared. And if you write it down on a pad, you also have it for future. You know, I mean, after you've done it. You can go back over it and go, okay, you know, and that way if you ever want to, just put together a second part of it, you got the first part right there.
Yeah.
Right.
Now you've got a music video that's been like all over the place. I saw it a while ago, and I remember seeing it. It brought
mm-hmm.
me right back to your artist page, but. Like, no matter how much I try to go around it to find some more music, it pops up all over the place. So I guess everybody's still raving about it. And that's a blessed thing to have a video just... I mean, is it at the point to where it's viral already?
It depends on what you call viral these days. My Facebook posting of it has about 40,000 views on it. And then on YouTube, there's about 16,000 views there. I released it to Christian Hip Hop Hits Just As Hard, and I saw that they've gained like 10,000 views from it or something. So, across the, in Reverb Nation also, there's about 21,000 views, I believe, on Reverb Nation. So if you add them all together, you may call it viral, but I know that it has been reaching people. I've been getting messages, with people saying that it has been a blessing to them to see it. And some people are just receiving gospel rap. They didn't even know it existed. Like, I didn't know it existed 4 years ago until I started writing it myself. And then something said, get online and look up gospel rappers. And I did it to see if it was out there. And that's when I started to discover, like, artists like Lecrae and The Truth and Bizzle and Thistle and, you know, even some of the other female artists who are on the East Coast. Like, we don't have many that I know of here in the South. But there's, you know, there's a few of us. And I went to Flavor Fest back in 2014 in Tampa, Florida, and it was a really nice experience, and I got to experience the entire culture of Christian hip-hop and Christian rappers and other ministers, and, everyone was, it was a nice time, and everyone was unified, and we came together in the name of the Lord and using music to inspire the next generation and to give God glory back in the earth, because so many times, you know, there's songs and material that's put out there that's negative and that has a negative impact on our communities. And the generations coming behind us, they need something inspirational. They need something positive to listen to. So when I see a young person saying, I love gospel rap, I think that's awesome, you know. So I didn't know the culture was out there, though, but it's a full-on industry behind it. So I think it's great. And I think that it's on the rise as well.
Oh, yeah. We coming for them. Now, you said there's the female rappers on the east side. Who all do you who all do you actually enjoy?
Well, actually, I had the chance to, at that time, I did not know who she was. Angie Rose, she was at Flavor Fest, and there was like this, it wasn't like a battle rap type of thing, but they were playing different beats, and we just came together like a cypher, kind of like, and I got a chance to hear her and learn who she was, and so, you know, I've definitely been following her. I know she just released some new visuals a few months ago. Who else? Allegra, she, I believe, is in Texas. I've heard some of her material before. I know about Heathon Lee and a few other people, Erica Mason, you know, I think, Kelly Glow. I had a chance to meet Kelly when I went to Atlanta to film my music video with director Will Thomas, and it was really nice, and the entire crew, everybody was wonderful. I actually started modeling when I was in Atlanta. That's how I started modeling. The makeup artist thought that I would make a great model for her company, and so I agreed to it while I was there, and we just kind of started rolling from there, and a few months after that, I signed with the modeling agency in Memphis, and I've been going on. I've done runway fashion shows since then. I've been a feature model for some photographers and boutiques, and through modeling, the door to acting opened as well, and I was casted as an extra on Queen Sugar, which is an American drama series on OWN Channel, on Oprah's network, and God has been really good to me. I didn't expect all of this to happen. I mean, I'm always in expectation of what God may do and what his next move is going to be, but I've been enjoying the ride and just going with the flow, and he's continuing to be strategic, and his will is being fulfilled, so I'm really excited about that. In a couple of weeks, I'm going to release another major accomplishment. I've heard I will be the first female Christian rapper or gospel rapper to do this particular thing, so I think I've kind of made strides in some other areas too, but this particular, you know, one announcement is going to be major, and I'm really excited about it, so...
Definitely.
And I don't want to keep talking about it too much. You know, I don't want to let it slip. I'm going to release it in 2 weeks. I'm going to post it on my social media. So.
Oh, man. So you got definitely tagged me in that, man, because I do want to spread it around. But see, I'm excited. So before
Absolutely.
I let my excitement go to my head and I start asking the wrong questions just to get everybody too curious about it, what is the deal with your last music video? Your song, You Ain't Preaching to the Choir.
Absolutely. It's my first video. It's my first video, and it's a charge to the body of Christ, and it's a challenge to say, go outside of the four walls of the church and meet people where they are. There's people who are homeless, people who are, you know, at a point in their life where they may be depressed, they may be suicidal, they may be oppressed by a situation, and they need for someone who knows God, who has that touch, to come and meet them where they are. So that's what it's about. If you saw that there was a guy that I was praying with in the video, kind of close to the end, he was actually in a homeless camp there in Atlanta when I visited there. So what you saw was actual ministry. As a matter of fact, I did not know that Will was capturing that shot at that moment when we were praying. So that was real ministry, real outreach that you saw. And for the past 4 years, I've been reaching out to the community in a heavy way. I've been to the foster homes with children and to prisons. I'm in prison ministry as well. And homeless ministry is really a big part of my heart of what I do. As a matter of fact, I was a case manager for about 3 years and working with people who were homeless, either They were living on the streets or in the woods in a tent or, you know, at an emergency shelter or a domestic violence situation. And I was able to help get them housed, their families housed, and to get them stabilized and to become self-sufficient. So I know that I hope that God is pleased, you know, and that people have been touched in some form or some fashion. And because that's what I'm compassionate about, is people and serving the community. And so that's all of what I am preaching to the choir is about. My son is giving me a hug right now. That's all of what I am preaching to the choir is about. Hey, go out into the hedges and the highways and the byways and find those lost souls, meet them where they are, believers, backsliders, whomever, and help them out, you know, bring them up into the kingdom and help to guide them, because we're believers. So we can't be selfish. We should not be selfish and have people who are within our area who need to receive the gospel and need to receive salvation. And we have not reached out to them to allow them and afford them that chance. Everyone is not being brought to church. I just was in a community where someone pulled me to the side and said, some of these children here are unchurched because their parents are unchurched. And so thank you for coming out. And that was a blessing. So I hope that, you know, I said something on that day that inspired them and they saw something that would compel them to go and find a church home that's word-based, you know, biblically based, and where they could be nurtured, you know, in that way. So, yeah, that's the inspiration behind Ain't Preaching to the Choir.
Beautiful.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, we're going to jump into this. Hope it blesses you guys, because I know when I heard it, it's hooky. It'll actually hook into you. It'll get stuck in your mind, and then you're going to have to go buy it. That's the best kind of music. Because when it gets stuck in your head, by the time you get it out of your head, you played it out so much to where you know the entire song word for word. So let's sing along, ladies and gentlemen, because I ain't preaching to the choir.
Preaching to the choir, cause they already believe it. I ain't preaching to the choir, cause they
beautiful song.
Thank you.
Yeah, we are back. We've been having too many technical difficulties today. The devil keeps trying to put his butt into it, trying to stop the Lord and Savior from having his people come together. He just mad because he keep failing at it.
Absolutely,
man.
And I see that you did a little bit of modeling. You talked a little bit about that. How? What are? Do you actually design some of your clothing, or do you have a personal stylist? How do you incorporate your style with, you know, what your music and all of that to make sure it stays appropriate for what, you know, what you do?
Both. I select some of my items on my own, and I also have a few stylists who I work with locally and even in some other places, other states that I may reach out to from time to time and see, you know, what they have on hand or what type of look they may be able to come up with for whatever concept or whatever, you know, event I may have going on. And it's just a matter of, you know, just keeping it classy, keeping it trendy and modest at the same time. So, but yeah, I choose some of my own pieces sometimes, and then other times I may, you know, get a stylist, hire a stylist. And sometimes you may see me with something on that I chose and the stylist chose. It just depends on what's going on and how much time we have. There's a lot of times it's, you know, this industry, the way things work is they move really fast, really quickly, and everyone's busy, and we, you know, just trying to come together and make it happen, but it always works out.
Wow.
Now, as far as the modeling, there's certain, let me just say this, because it may be some young ladies who are listening out who are, you know, are Christians or believers and may have a passion for modeling. You don't have to accept every job that comes your way, every offer that comes your way. Let me just say that I know that, you know, you may want opportunities and you may feel like, well, if I don't do this, the door may close on me, or if I don't hang out, you know, here, then I may not be able to pursue my modeling. That's not true. You know, there's certain jobs and they come my way. If it's like not modest, if it's not something that I know that I would do as a person, as a woman, as a mother, as a wife, and as a Christian, I would say, you know, I don't go for those calls. I don't go for those jobs. I don't go to those casting calls. And even if it's offered to me, you know, I'll let them know, hey, this is what I can do and this is what I cannot do. And if we can agree on that, then we can make it work. But if we can't, then
absolutely,
I'm sorry. You know, I can't jeopardize myself, my character, my reputation, or my brand just to take one photo from you that can totally mess up everything. So,
absolutely.
You know, be mindful in the jobs that you choose, and you can still pursue it, though, and still be a Christian at the same time. Keep it classy.
And absolutely, and I really feel that because I have a special interest in your style and what you do, because my image as an artist is the music model. So I do a lot of modeling myself. And I would love to collaborate with you. When you model, do you what type of modeling do you actually like to select, like fashion editorial, fashion runway? Do you do the catalog, commercials, bulk modeling? Do you kind of cover all of that, or do you just kind of stay in one realm of modeling?
Since I began, I've had a little bit of each one to come my way. I had an opportunity to do a high fashion editorial, and they ended up changing cities, and so I was not able to make it to that city. Something happened, and one event didn't happen, so that one didn't happen as well. But I did have an offer to do a high fashion editorial shoot. I really love commercial print, and I think I want to, you know, I kind of want to stick to commercial print and, like, travel magazines. I'm passionate about that. I love runway. Runway is great, but I see that I'm more connected when, you know, when it's like a personal setting with me and the photographer, or maybe even a group of people, and, you know, we're just going for commercial print shots and you know, publications for magazines and things of that nature. I really like that. My actual first professional photo shoot, y'all believe this, when I signed with the modeling agency in Memphis, the photographer that they brought on is the same person who discovered Naomi Campbell in London. And
oh, wow.
I was really excited. I know, right? And she told me, you know, while we were doing the photo shoot, and she said, you really should go for commercial print and travel magazine. She said, you know, it's a pretty lucrative side of the business, and I think you would do well in it. I think you would do great. And, you know, that was helpful to me, you know, in finding out what I really wanted to do, because, like I said, modeling just kind of happened with me. And then I found out, hey, I really do like this. And I love being on set even more, you know, with the acting and everything. But, yeah, I want to collaborate with you as well and see some of your work and all of that, because I've been working on my branding and wanting to – because, see, people look at me, and then when my voice comes out, it's kind of like, hey, your voice doesn't sound like how you look, or you don't look like you have a voice like that. And the clothing kind of helps to – express, I would say, that, hey, I am a rapper. Yes, I am beautiful, but hey, I am a rapper at the same time. But there's so much more that I do than just the music. I have a children's book that's getting ready to come out in a few short months here. I want to release it shortly after school starts in August. So,
wow.
You know, there's so many different things that I'm doing.
Absolutely.
That
somewhere
I don't think I can
like be. Oh, I'm listening. I'm just really shocked that you're mentioning all of this, because I actually have a children program that is already out. I'm working on it even the more. I'm collaborating with during Mrs. Obama to do a certificate program with me for children. So I'm definitely doing something for the kids as well. So I like listening to you is like, oh my goodness, I would love to just collaborate with her. Because we share a lot of interests together. Like our thinking process is like the same, the modeling, the children stuff, the singing. Wow, I think it'll be amazing mm-hmm. for us to come together. And what's so funny is I just passed through Jackson, Mississippi, going to Louisiana and coming from Louisiana. And
wow.
I definitely remember being in that area. I actually stopped by a hair store there trying to see what kind of different wigs y'all had in Mississippi.
Did you find your white girl?
I did. It's totally different
great.
From what I see in Florida. So I thought that was very interesting.
Well,
okay.
Hey, Tiffany.
I wasn't expecting that this morning. I'm so glad to be on.
Yeah, this is one of those things where all the guys are like excluded from this, because all the guys that's listening to this have no idea what's going on anymore. You done lost us that hair stuff.
Yeah. Well,
none of my fellas out here can relate.
Miss Tiffany, I watched the Queen Sugar on OWN. I've been following it for a while now, and how did you get into that on that program? I mean, was the opportunity just open to you, or
it just happened just like that? I tell you, I'll try to make the story a little bit short. You heard me say that the gift of modeling was stirred in Atlanta, and when that happened, when I got home a few months after that, I signed with the modeling agency, and so. Then all of a sudden, things started to happen on social media, and then I was being contacted by different photographers, or, you know, there's one particular company that she has an event. Her name is Tamika Garrett. She has an event called Stilettos on the Pavement. Shout out to Tamika. She's here in Jackson, and she does a lot of work in Atlanta as well and California. And Tamika asked me, she said, would you like to come on this photo shoot here for the event? And I said, yes, you know, I'm like, I love the opportunity. I'll come. You know, and work with you. And we've grown, you know, we've become really good friends. And the photographer there asked if I ever thought about acting before. And I said, yes, I have, you know, a little bit. And I would be interested in doing that. And there was actually the stirring of the gift of acting as well. And he said, well, I have a few friends who are casting directors, and I'm going to send your information their way, or I send you some stuff, and you follow the instructions, and you send it to them, and it happened just like that.
Wow. Okay. That's amazing.
Through a photo shoot. So that's awesome. You know, I did. It was just a photo shoot with you know, for someone else, and I was just obedient to God, and I said, yeah, I'll come and help you out, and it ended up opening a door for me, and it has been that way since the beginning of this year. It's like one door opens another, and another opens, and it's just been like a domino effect, but not falling down, rising up.
Amen. That's God. That's God. That's God. Hey, I mean, God opens doors, and all we got to do is walk through them, and He gives us all the opportunities that we can handle. He doesn't try to give us too more than we can handle. But congratulations on getting the role. I mean, I like watching a lot of Tyler Perry stuff on OWN too as well, the Have and Have Nots, and
yeah.
I mean, he's a blessed writer, that's why I started following the OWN channel, and it's definitely been the Queen Sugar has been a great program so far. I can't wait to see what the new season is going to bring. It's been pretty good.
I can't talk a whole lot about it because we need to sign releases and waivers and all that stuff. So, maybe I can tell you the episode. If the parts that I was in, the things make the edits. It was episode 209/210, and I believe the last one that just came on was like maybe 4 or 5. So we still have a couple more episodes to go before that particular one is released. Yeah.
Okay. All right. Well, I'll be looking for it.
Just watch Queen Sugar.
Yeah, I'm gonna try to check that out because I mean, I'm sitting here. Everybody seems to love that. I mean, I never heard of it, but then again, I don't watch TV. I ain't got time. So I mean, if I can find it online somewhere, I'll watch it on the go. I'll just be too busy. But no, you brought a song with you, titled Grace 2.0.
Yeah.
Tell us about that song.
Grace 2.0. Okay. So it was originally named Grace, right? And then I changed the beat. I wanted to do something different with the beat. And so that's where the 2.0 came in. And so it's like, this is the second version of Grace. Then I also started to notice that lots of people had a song called Grace. And so I thought, well, this will set it apart. The 2.0 would definitely set the song Grace apart from the other songs that are entitled with the same title. But anyway, it's about the grace of God. It's sharing a little bit of my testimony. We've all come from a place and have come through the things that we've been through or either in transition with coming through those things. And it's only by the grace of God. And so the chorus says, or the hook says, I am who I am. I don't know who I would be if it wasn't for the grace of God. I don't know where I would be. Somewhere headed for the tomb, then you probably RIP, but they can't take me out the game because Jesus got the master key. The wicked hating that I'm out here because I'm finna take cheese. Lord, prepare a table for me. I'll feed my enemies. Grace, grace, grace. And that's how it goes. So it's really, it's just kind of saying, hey, I've been in a place. God has brought me out of that place. And now this is what he's getting ready to do by his grace, by his spirit.
Well, dang.
Awesome.
I mean, if you'd have kept going for a second, I was like, man, you should have just sent the instrumental. We'll just do it live like a performance here, live on the show. You gotta start doing
have.
That. But I tell you
that
what, I have not listened to the song yet. I wanted to listen to it live on the air.
Awesome.
I do that from time to time with different music. If I know that the person's a gospel artist, and they're not just going to start dropping F-bombs and stuff. So, I mean, once I know you're good, I tend to do that with new songs because I want to, like, hear it fresh, and I want to hear everyone's opinion about it. So is this song available now, or is this upcoming?
It's upcoming. It has been released to your station and to a few other stations. It's playing on The Next Big Thing, which is part of it's a show that's airing on a radio station in Monroe, Louisiana. And then it's also playing, it has played in some other countries as well through an online internet radio podcast, things of that nature. So it actually was first played back in January with Tanya, Angels of Melody, and she, you know, she loved it, and she continues to play it, so I thank God for that. But, yeah, So it has not been released on digital outlets yet. I have not officially released the single, but it's coming up. I'm still trying to tell, am I going to release this entire EP? Or just someone said, you should just keep pushing singles out. I'm like, I don't know. I want to finish this work because I have another project. I'm working on project two, and I know I definitely want to release it next year. So I've got to go ahead and get I Am Preaching to the Choir, the EP, out this year. I hope to release it in October for my birthday. My birthday is October the 28th, so it would be cool to do a release party with like a birthday bash or something.
Now that would be cool.
Awesome.
Definitely.
Yeah, that will be.
Well, let's check it out, ladies and gentlemen. This is Miz Tiffany with Grace 2.0. It's rehearsed that Jesus gave me my own birth. I can't rap that good, so I ain't finna keep going because I'm just making a fool of myself. But it's okay, this is my show. What? We dig it right now. I was trying to say.
Wow.
I mean, that was whack. I did it that whack on purpose. I was trying to make y'all laugh, but I was seriously listening to it. I'm sitting there like, man, I could definitely see coming in on like the second verse. I really could.
Hey,
I don't know.
You know
I don't
what?
Normally do straight rap. I normally get melodic with it, but that would be right. Let's talk about it. Oh, we're going to, yeah, let's talk about it. Shoot. I'm down with it because, I mean, I've been listening to so much rap lately. I normally get melodic and just, you know, try to keep tunes throughout all of my songs, but I don't know. Something's just been calling me to go just straight out rapping on it. I think that it's going to be something I'm going to endeavor on my next album.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah. Yeah, we're going to talk, definitely.
Please do. So
now, let me ask.
No, go ahead.
No, go ahead. What are you saying?
No, I was just going to say, make sure y'all, you know, send me messages and follow up so we can get together and network and see what else we might be able to do. I don't think this was just a coincidence. And yes, it came in the name of, you know, the radio interview, but there's so much more work to be done. So I'm open.
See, nothing like that happens to the body of Christ. I tell people all the time, man, you can ask everyone that has ever met me over the past couple of years. You know, the Bible stipulates a house divided cannot stand. And so the devil's house is united completely. They're working hard against us. That's why it's so tough to fight against them, because the body of Christ is so divided and segregated that, you know, somebody wants to be the arm, somebody wants to be the leg, but the person that wants to be the hand wants to be way over there, disconnected from the body and do their own thing. Next thing you know, we just have literally no unity in the body of Christ. But when God's hand is up on something, he brings his people together in real unity. And when he can bring people of different races, different backgrounds, and just say, forget what you've done, forget what you did, you know, forget what you look like. We all come together because we're Christ's likeness, and we want to bless him. We want to praise his name and worship him together. There's no more beautiful sight than that outside of the Savior himself. That's just how I feel.
Amen.
I didn't mean to get all like that deep on this, because normally this is a more fun show. But hey, the whole point is there's no such thing as coincidence. God is large and in charge. He has his hand on everything. And so things always happen for a reason. If they're good, then they'll bless you. If they're bad, then they'll be used to give you an experience to do something bigger.
Amen.
And in the words of Steve Harvey, and this is for all the artists out there, in the words of Steve Harvey, a setback is just a set up for your comeback. So keep that in mind. If you think you failed at something, it's going to get better.
You are love.
Well, we've got a few minutes left of the show. If anybody were to want to get a hold of you for a collaboration or to book you for a performance or anything of that nature, an interview, how would they be able to get a hold of you?
Okay, so you can contact me at bookmisstiffany@gmail.com. That's bookmisstiffany@gmail.com. Bookmisstiffany@gmail.com. Also, you can reach out on social media, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, Reverb Nation. I'm on YouTube as well. You can find me at official Miss Tiffany. That's officialmisstiffany at official Miss Tiffany. I also have a website that I am rebuilding right now, but it's www.misstiffany.com. So reach me there, and we can talk about booking, features, anything, whatever, and see how we can make it work.
Definitely. And if anybody, this is going to be archived, so if you guys are listening later on this week on YouTube or Facebook on the archived version of this episode, just look down to the drop box with all the details and information. It's going to have her email and all of her social media links there. If you find Gospel Wave on any social media, we're already following her. We follow everybody. We're very adamant about really supporting the artists that we bring on the show, because why would we sleep on the people that are the stars of tomorrow? You know, I'm sure one day Lecrae was like, man, you know, I'm going to rap, and nobody believed in him. Now look at him. He's the most popular Christian artist on the planet. There you go. All you got to do is have a dream. But nah, Miss Tiffany, I really appreciate you coming on the show today. I was excited about this show because I really wanted to get your testimony on what you do and how you do it. And I think you and Kimmie K would definitely do some good work together, because you're both into music and you're both into modeling. So I really do look forward to see if you guys put something together.
Absolutely. And yeah. I'm ready. Can you send me a message? Make sure you send me a message. I really do want to talk to you and make sure that we get connected.
Okay. Absolutely.
Hey, man, I can see that happening too.
What was that?
Late.
I said, amen, I can see that happening too. You guys will make a great duo.
Amen. To God be the glory.
Oh, that
make
a great
duo.
You said that so fast, man. It sounded like, I'm like, what?
Wait,
Kingdom Hearts
Chic
is the fastest rapper that I personally know. Now, Kingdom Hearts Chic is the fastest rapper that I personally know, and I can't understand what she say when she rap. I mean, she got Eminem outbeat like three times as fast. So, I don't know. But, ladies and gentlemen, definitely check out Miss Tiffany's work. Her next projects that she'll be dropping will definitely be featured on our page. And, Tiffany, you're welcome back on the show anytime you want, whether as a guest or even you can come on and co-host with us sometime. Lord willing.
Wow, thank you. Yes, I would love to.
Definitely, ladies and gentlemen. Lord willing, we're going to catch you next Monday, same time, same place, different link, obviously. But always keep that number 646-716-7958. We're going to end on Adrian Blue's new single, Walk With Jesus. And don't forget, tonight it will be available, so check it out. It'll be promoted on all of our pages. But God bless you guys, and we love you all.
Nah, dangerous endeavors to stray from the past that God has us on. Living life moment to moment, all that's left in the fragments. Left a piece of yourself in the ground feeling tragic. So take a leap of faith. Take a dive off a cliff and have the faith that you'll be carried by a grace. Still clinging to a place, hoping to vanish without a trace. Too afraid of my digression, that's been my crying obsession now. Way too many lives have been lost, passing away from our vanity. Seems to jeopardize faith in it all, but we made that call. That's the narrow path that we chose.
No one said it'd be easy, but that's the only path that we know.
Faith be shown,
words be known,
spirit grown,
life be whole.
Call us to the Savior from a place that's black and cold.
If I don't have a purpose for the Savior, then just close your eyes, 'cause in a few moments my soul will be dead and gone.